Okay, so where is this leading me to, all of this work on this spindle? Well, I can tell you that I just carved this piece here, and it's better than this 4 inches I just carved. I stuck it out of there about five, out of here, about five. And it's within tenths from here to here. Almost dead balls within tenths. Almost, I mean, not even tenths, a tenth. So a tenth over 4 inches on a 1-270-year-old machine, good. Why is all of this really important? Well, it's my knowledge that Logan supplied these machines on stands or without the stand, bench lathes, the 820s and the 920s with a 6-inch chuck, which is what this is. This is a Chinese chuck, cost me right just around a little under 200 beans. It's a 4-jaw, definitely made in China. I've already deburred all of the screws and the jaws, and I have it chucked in here. And the reason is because I have to fix the back plate. And the back plate is threaded a mile long. But what I wanted to show you guys was, I don't know if we're seeing this dial here. Are we seeing this dial here? Oh, hey, not so fast there. Not so fast. Okay, so, yeah. That's supposedly on zero if I ain't bunking it. And that is a Browning shack. And so now I've taken my rubber plastic hammer, which I wish I could buy an ends for anymore these days. But I got nothing in there. Nothing. And, of course, it's probably 40 degrees out here in the garage, but no heat comes out of them bearings. It's excellent. But the reason I'm showing you that indicator is because the best accurate way, and I'm going to show you why, hopefully I got tape and battery here, is I taking the back plate, and I'm going to show you here in a second as soon as we get off of this. I need an accurate way to chuck this back plate, and I have to do that in this chuck because it's the best. It's new and it's better than this 3-jaw chuck. This here is too big, which probably brings me to half the beatings that happened to this lathe right here came because they got this 8-inch chuck instead of the 6. Now, if you're competent, you can use an 8-inch chuck. It's come in handy because, you know, bigger stuff, it's just handy. I got this here brown and shappy. Hopefully you guys are seeing that on my tooth where I'm going with the back plate. And I'm at zero on that tooth. Come around, don't hit nothing. Drop it back on there. Right near zero. Again, hopefully you're seeing that again. I probably banged this. That's what happens when you make a tape for YouTube. But it's inside 1,000, even after I bang it. There's zero again. I just did this before I turned the camera on and it was zeros everywhere. So there you go. Another zero. And another zero. And another zero. So there, we bang it back. Zero. 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 So I'm going to call it within a 0.5 thousand of being flat there. So anything I go in them jaws with, at least at that area, I'm going to be good at. Here is the back plate. And I can step over here and show you that this is the spindle that I changed out yesterday. This is, best of my knowledge, the original spindle. And this does not go all the way in. It runs up to where the shoulder is and stops. So I got to fix the ID on the back plate. Plus, there's 9 miles of thread sticking out of there. So I already did, there ain't a whole lot of extra meat here. I want this on there. I got to have that locating shoulder, which doesn't fit the chuck neither. It's oversized. They did not fit that. I got to fit that, which is why I waited the almost 4 years now since this has been on my rotary table. The chuck's been on the rotary table, and the back plate's been in the bottom drawer in this oil rag here. But you could see it is 9 miles. So with some hokey pokey mat somewhere here, I got a sheet. You can't use my numbers on your machine. But if you buy one of these, I want to say that the seller on eBay was Tools for Cheap. Maybe I got that wrong. I hope I don't got that wrong, because there was definitely a spammer guy that was on the Logan Lathe Farms in Yahoo, and I wouldn't use him. This guy was in Massachusetts, right down the street. Of course, I had to pay the shipping anyway. The thing showed up, and it was pretty good. I got that video on you the day I got the chuck and a rotary table, which I won't mention here. However, it was damn good for the money. Just under $400, delivered to the house, 6-inch rotary table that the chuck bolts to with no mods. All I had to do was make some better different screws so I could get a socket in there to tighten it up. So that being said, now I got to figure out how to get this on there. Let's see what happens. Okay, you guys. So, yep, I got the chuck, the 6-inch inside the 8-inch, and I got the back plate inside there. And that's the 10th Mighty Toy again, which is probably too fine for this job because it's just a cast iron as turned finish. And you can see she's just rumpling maybe 3/10. Hopefully you're seeing that there. The difference between numbers on that is 1,000. And every line, every grad is 1/10. So hopefully this is, you can see this here. And just touching the chuck, but you can see that 3/10. So that's about as straight as I'm going to get that. And I just got to pull that rig off of there and hook me up a tool. And I got to take about 300 thou off of here, about my finger thickness, a little less than that, off of that so I can get the spindle inside of there. And we will be using this spindle for a checker tool. That chuck was certainly not fit for that spindle. And I don't know if it was even fit for the other spindle. I do know that the giant jaws on that are a little bit wallered out. So she grabs better the deeper you go into jaws. These are the outside jaws, and these are in real good condition, probably because they never got used. But the inside jaws are certainly walled out. And if I had a ground, a big fat ground washer, I probably would stick that, my little tool, my live tool post grinder in there and clean those up a little bit. And I may do that in the future, just for ha-has. As soon as I figure out how to get something that's a little bit ID, concentric-y, that I could actually use to put the jaws under tension. So let me get this rig off of here and get a tool in there, and we'll go from there. Okay, you guys, so just for ha-has, what we're going to do is, now that this is in here, I know I need to take 300, 310 off, which will still leave it about 100,000 longer than this here, which I'm doing only because I wasn't smart enough to see where the threads ended off in there. However, it probably doesn't need to be, and I'd be protecting the threads inside the inside of here. In case you're sticking materials in, you're not beating the nose of the thing. This here's my rendition of a quick change tool post. It's been all milled, machined on the machine, so it fits. So I take this I needed this when I was making bushings for the pulley and all. You guys can go back and watch that video. I'll supposedly have links here and there. But just a little, and we're just going to, by my measurements, now 1/4-inch tool bit, as long as you're grinding them right, everything is good if you just stick it in the hole. Stick it in the slot and the tool's on center. Simple as that. Preserving the, when we grind the sharpened, we never touch the top. That's the factory top edge. That leaves it, as long as I'm not bending it, it leaves it good. And it's good for brass, and I just been cutting everything. The measurement here is 6,000 under And now yours may measure different, but I got, what did I say? 2 inches, 285, approximate. And that is the finish. That's what I measured the spindle at. And this measures in at 79. And so just for ha-ha-has, we're going to, just cut, this is all leaving anyway. We're going to clean that right off of there, because I don't need all that. And it don't fit any, oh, can I get that in there like that? No. Okay, yeah, I got to get another wrench to spin that. You guys ain't see that. You don't need to see that. Yeah. All right, whatever, you can see it. Yeah, all I got to do is spin this like this so I can get that in there, all right? Yep, and yeah, I made the roundy dovetail on there. I don't know if I made video about that. Probably didn't. Can I get that in there like that? Maybe I can't use this one on that. Where is it? Where's the low side? Maybe I can't use this one on this here. Because of the, what do you call it? I only got to go 6,000, so can I stick that out some more and actually make that work for me? I think I can. I think I can. Tighten that up. What'd I say? Okay. Yeah, we only got to clean 6,000 out of this, so this is actually going to cut pretty easy because it's cast iron. And so we'll just give myself a little bit more length, and we'll be using a heavier bar and bar when it comes to finishing this off of here. Something a little bit heavier, because I have not yet took the time to make anything any bigger. Can I get that in there now? Oh, yes. Goes well inside the treads. So, yeah. And we're not going to be taxing it. So, I could actually get a little more out of it, but I ain't gonna, because I just don't need to. Because, like I said, this is for ha-has. We just don't need to. No need to. If you don't need to, yeah, tighten that up a little bit. She ain't no big, we ain't doing no hogging on this. Like I said, it's only $6,000. Yeah. Jeez, this is not quiet that thing is anymore these days. All I want to do is touch this. When I get in there, it's going to hit that thread, which is why we're going to use a bigger boring ball after. This is just a test. So now it's about, and you guys probably haven't seen that video yet, but I have made new lead screw nut for this, and so it's all good, wicked good. So it's 6,000 is all we are. So on the dial, I'm going to bring me on. I am going to bring me on a 2,000 cut. That's it. And send this at light speed. Because I made a gear for this, for the fine feed. And you guys will see that video over here. It's supposedly, hopefully my measurements are good. Hopefully you guys are seeing that. It's all good. And that is just powder. So that was a 2,000 put on, which should turn into 4,000 opening. And so all we're going to do is clean the snot out of there, and then and stick that in. And when it gets close to my little magic marker, we're going to shut off the power feed and just touch that thread. By hand, I don't know if you guys are hearing it, but I can hear it. clean out of there. Yeah, just dust, magnetic. I'll show you how I deal with that in the future. Okay. Very fine powdery dust. And let's just stick that in there one more time real quick, like, and see if it's actually taking 2,000 at a whack on that tool. It's still cutting, it's springing. If it ain't, it ain't. Definitely touching. Probably should have just checked that. We're hoping that it's just a shad tight. And I don't even have to bring any more on the tool. It's just going to do it. For us homie guys, once you get under a thousandth of an inch in measuring tools, you know, we're probably fudging below there. Unless you can make a gauge and check it against three different tools. Little oil rag, suck up some of that dust. Suck up some of that dust. Okay, you get that thing. Okay, so here's the spindle. And let's try this. If I got enough room in here, get over my tool. And see if that actually worked for me. I don't have enough room in here like that. Do I or don't I? No. God dang it. God dang it. Gotta give myself another half an inch, what she said. Yeah. Oh, it just wants to start. I can feel it. All right, get that out of there real quick. Like, all right, so you guys see the program here. I'm going to shut this down before I run out of battery. Yeah, and as soon as I get that on there, I'll show you again.